my little party animals. Hiphiprenee here today with a brand new speed build for you. And today we are starting on San Myshuno. Finally, I am so excited to finally be doing some apartments. And I'm sure, or I hope, that on Friday you guys noticed that I had put out the Sigma Phi household, which is basically a group of fraternity brothers who have graduated from college and are now all living in an apartment together, and this is their apartment. So I created all of the Sims on Friday, and today we are looking at their apartment. So this house, or this apartment rather, is, I believe it's 701 Zenview. I think the other one is 702. I can never remember which one is which. I did end up changing the name to Sigma Phi Apartment. This is not currently in the gallery. I am likely going to add it to the gallery, but I'm going to have to do two uploads with this because it is an apartment, so you have to upload it as a room. And of course, because it's two floors on this apartment, you can't upload it, let you know, like as a lot or anything like that. You do have to upload it as two separate rooms. So that is something that I will probably be doing. If you do want to download this from the gallery, just keep in mind that you'll kind of have to piecemeal it back together. You'll have to add back in whatever walls I end up deleting. But I think it's a super cute apartment. I really, really love this. And what I did is downstairs, so this is a two-floor apartment, and I feel like, you know, kind of the normal layout of this apartment is you go downstairs, there's the living room, there's the kitchen, and then all of the bedrooms are upstairs. And I was like, eh, you know, that's fine and dandy and something that everybody does, but I want to try something a little bit different here. So what I did is you walk into the apartment and you walk into a living space. So this is a nice little living space that has, you know, just kind of some books lying around. Their book bags are lying around. There's some notebooks. There is a TV. There's all sorts of video games down here. So this is just kind of like a nice communal area for the guys to hang out together and, you know, just kind of sit around. If they have guests over, this is likely where they will be hanging out. But then instead of doing the kitchen downstairs along with this living space, I actually did the kitchen upstairs, and they have an entirely separate living area upstairs. So downstairs you have a nice little living space, you have a bathroom that has toilet, sink, and shower, and then there is one of the bedrooms downstairs. So if you did not watch the Create a Sim video for these gentlemen, there are four fraternity brothers. I almost call them sorority brothers. That doesn't make sense. There's no boys in sororities. But there are four fraternity brothers in this, and they all have very separate and distinct personalities. Kind of the idea that I am going for with San Myshuno is I'm trying to create the most stereotypical Sims that you would possibly find. So I thought that was really fun to just kind of go, you know, really out there with it and be a little bit ridiculous as far as creating these Sims and then going in and creating some really cool spaces for them to live in. So downstairs, this first bedroom that we are working on, this is the bedroom that holds, there's a party guy and there's a nerd. So those two share a room, which I thought was really funny because they are definitely the most opposite as far as everybody that is living in the house. So we have, you know, a jock, we have a really pretty boy, we have a nerd, and we have a party animal. So I kind of thought the nerd and the party guy together, I thought that was a fun kind of little juxtaposition of, you know, just types of people that might live together. It doesn't seem like these two would be the first two to get along. But, you know, turns out that they are actually really, really good friends. So you can kind of tell that over on the right side of the bedroom, that is the partier's side of the room. It is very messy, very dirty. And then over on the left side is the much neater space of kind of the more geeky sort of guy. And again, all of these Sims are very, very stereotypical. I am not meaning to cause any offense by any of these. It's just, I am just going with, again, the most stereotypical that you can find for all of San Myshuno, not just for this apartment. So this apartment, we have the frat boys. In the apartment next door in the same building, we have the sorority sisters, who basically have all four of the female counterparts to the gentlemen that live in this apartment, which I think is really funny that they live right next to each other. You know, maybe at some point I will play with them. Maybe they'll end up dating each other and, you know, just kind of see what kind of havoc we can cause. I am also creating a crazy cat lady apartment. I'm going to do, you know, a really fun laid back single dad. I'm going to do a really hardworking single mom. So really kind of just anything that is very stereotypical as far as Sims townies are concerned. Because I feel like Sims townies, you get people like Don Lothario, who is very stereotypically like a lady killer. He is, you know, he's a Don Juan. He kind of goes around and just flirts with every single Sim that you can find. And then you have people like Marcus Flex, who is constantly at the gym. He's like a really big built kind of guy. All of the townies in The Sims, or not all of them, but a lot of them, I feel like are very stereotypical. So that's what I was going with here. So upstairs, we do have, of course, the kitchen that we are currently working on. It's just a very nice, put together kind of kitchen. I felt like since the guy who is the partier lives downstairs, that the downstairs might be a little bit more messy, a little bit more cluttered. He would likely spend more of his time down there. I can't imagine that he's going to come up here for more than really just kind of like cooking. And even when he is cooking, it's likely that he's eating ramen or cereal. He doesn't seem like the type of person to be like, I'm going to cook myself a meal. Whereas some of the other guys that live in this apartment, you know, are probably a little bit more adulty than the party guy. So, you know, they all have their little personalities. I think it was really fun to come up with their personalities and then be able to work on this apartment because I had a nice distinct direction to go in as far as creating all of their bedrooms and creating their living spaces. Again, I know we don't have university in the game. I don't think that these guys are like still in college. I was kind of going with the idea that they were in a fraternity together, and now that they have all graduated and, you know, got their entry level jobs and things like that, that they are, you know, they were friends for so long. They can't afford their own apartments in San Myshuno, so they have all moved in together, and they've always been friends and they just get along really well. So that's what I was going for here. This bedroom that we are currently working on is the bedroom of, like, the athlete. So he's, you know, he's kind of got, like, the long hockey hair, if you will. He is a little bit stuck up. He's a little bit conceited. He's a little bit of a pretty boy. And his room is, you know, just very simple. There's really not a lot going on in his room. He does have the smallest bedroom in the house, so, you know, that was a little bit challenging to kind of work with this tiny little space that we had here, but I think it works out fine. And then this final bedroom this is kind of like the most put together guy in this apartment. So he is the pretty boy. There is the potential that, you know, maybe he is possibly gay. His room is very nice, very put together. He's always been really popular. He's just a very nice person. He probably works in business. I think I actually made his career. It's either business or politics. I don't remember off the top of my head. But when I did upload this household, they all had skills already kind of put together. They all had jobs already put together. They were promoted to different levels in their job. So they're kind of like really nice pre-made Sims for you. They are up on my gallery, so you can definitely go download them if you would like to play with them. I believe I already have the sorority sisters uploaded as well. Possibly the crazy cat lady. I don't remember if I have already uploaded her or not. I know that she is on my list of things to do. I know I already created her. I know I already created her apartment. I just don't know if I uploaded her yet. But we are, of course, heading into the screenshot. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this apartment. I hope you like this, you know, little series within a series where we're recreating San Myshuno and recreating all of the Sims in San Myshuno. If you guys have any other suggestions for stereotypical type Sims that you would like to see in San Myshuno, definitely leave me a comment down below. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are new here or you're not new here and you're not subscribed yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit that little bell so you get notifications every single time I post a new video. I will see you guys on Wednesday with a brand new episode of the A to Z Build Challenge. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you next time. Bye.